Apple recently announced that the iOS 14 public beta is available. But how is it performing on the iPhone SE and what features are available? Let's start with the home screen. The only difference we see on the home screen is the new widgets. They look really good and are a nice addition to the iPhone. We can now size them the way we want. The app library is also a great addition, especially to the smaller iPhone SE. It removes all the clutter from the home screen. We can also hide other home screens, which is great if you want to keep that page but don't really use it. These two features are great changes, especially to the iPhone SE. Picture-in-picture also works surprisingly well on the iPhone SE. It's super smooth and works very well. You can resize it and swipe it away. There's also picture-in-picture for FaceTime calls. These features were available in iOS 9 for the iPads, but we finally get them for the iPhone. There's also a new feature in iOS 14 called Compact UI. This is in many parts of the OS, but not in all. Siri doesn't take up the full screen anymore and looks great in a new user interface. You can now send audio messages with Siri, which is a good change. By default, you can't see what she heard from your voice, but if you turn on a setting in Siri and search, you can see what she hears. If you want to edit what she heard, just tap on the text and a window pops up with a keyboard. However, I do think that the new Siri interface is flawed for one major reason. First of all, you can't talk to Siri and use your iPhone at the same time. So what's the point of it being in the corner if you can't interact with the iPhone? So overall, the new Siri UI looks great, but it doesn't work perfectly. We also got a new call UI, which finally does not take up the entire screen. You can still interact with the display though, so that's good. Hopefully, we see that logic apply to the new Siri UI. There's also Compact UI in many other parts of the OS. For example, let's say your time is up for YouTube with screen time. If you tap Ignore Limit, you no longer get a pop-up and instead get a small menu. But hopefully this is applied everywhere, it's just low battery alerts. We also get a new Translate app, which is glitchy, but that's expected in this beta stage. One thing I noticed it does better over Google Translate is that it actually applies the grammar to the sentences, such as commas. Safari also got a few upgrades. First of all, we now have a super cool privacy report. It shows you how many trackers each website uses that you visit. It also shows you what trackers you are using. Websites also load noticeably faster, which is a great improvement. You can now also translate pages on Safari. It's not working for me, but that's fine because it's a beta. I've also noticed some UI changes. At this point, I really see no reason why to use Chrome when Safari is just so much faster and has better privacy. The Notes app also got a good upgrade with some new features. It looks nicer and it now also autocorrects shapes. So let's say I draw a square but it's not perfect. If I just hold for a couple more seconds, it makes it perfect. It also can copy handwriting. So let's say I write the tech person. I can just hold onto it and copy it as text or as handwriting. I can then paste this anywhere, which is just amazing. It can also detect information. So let's say I write a phone number or a date. You notice that it gets underlined and you can hold on it to take action on that information. For example, create a contact for the phone number or create a reminder or calendar event for the date. This is a cool feature, but I don't see myself using it very often or at all. These features were mainly designed for the iPad, but they are still available for all iPhones that are capable of running iOS 14. Voice Memos also has a few cool new features. You can now create folders to organize your recordings, and you can now enhance your recordings with a single tap. I have tested this and I can confirm it works pretty well. All black elements have now been replaced with white in light mode, so it's more consistent when switched to dark mode. Messages also got a huge upgrade in iOS 14. You can now pin up to 9 conversations, which is a great change. You can now also mention people in their inline replies. My favorite feature though is the pinned conversations. The camera app also got some small but noticeable upgrades. First of all, you can now finally change the video resolution within the app, and I have noticed that taking pictures feels slightly faster. You can now also mirror the front camera in the settings, which I like. We also get the sound recognition feature, which can notify you when there is a certain noise in the background. For example, if water is running, you will get a notification. Or if a fire alarm sounds, you will get a notification. This will be very useful when wearing noise-canceling earbuds, such as AirPods Pro, or for people who can't hear well. There are also a lot of new privacy features. For example, now if you paste something you've copied, you will get a banner. This may not seem like a privacy feature, but it is. Many apps have been caught spying on clipboards with this feature. You can now also just give access to just photos you want instead of all photos in apps. You also don't need to share your exact location with apps. Instead, you can just share your approximate location in apps that may not need your exact location. iCloud Keychain also tells you which passwords need to be changed. A dot also shows up at the top of the screen whenever an app is using your microphone or camera. It also shows you which app used the mic or camera in the control center, so great changes in the privacy department. The iPhone SE also gets a new sleep tracking feature, and you don't need an Apple Watch to use it. I don't find it useful personally, but it's a nice addition to the Health app. The iPhone SE will also get app clips. It's not available now, but it will be available in a future version of iOS 14, such as 14.1. The iPhone SE will also have the ability to set default apps. It's not currently available, but it will come in a later beta. You can now also search for emojis. I'm also noticing a lot of smaller changes, such as the ability to add captions to photos, which is a welcome change, slightly different animations when there's a notification, different animation when opening a folder, and screenshots show up faster when taking them. There's also a new color picker when marking up screenshots, documents, or photos. There's also a new date and time picker, which I personally love because it's way faster. I never loved the functionality of the old one because it was so slow. So these are pretty much all the changes in iOS 14. What's great though is that they are all available on the iPhone SE, but there are also some features only exclusive to newer devices. First of all, the iPhone SE does not get card key. This is not a huge deal because very, very few cars support it for now. The iPhone SE also doesn't get the back tap feature, but only Face ID iPhones get that feature, which means even the 2020 iPhone SE didn't get it. And finally, we made it to the last thing on the list, performance and bugs. This is important and makes it or breaks it for an iOS or iPadOS update. But iOS 14 feels about the same as iOS 13. It just feels a tiny bit more stuttery in some areas, but nothing major. Keep in mind this is a beta though, and it will be greatly improved as always. Surprisingly, this beta is performing amazingly in terms of bugs. That doesn't mean there are no bugs whatsoever, but the bugs that are present are very minor. But unlike last year with iOS 13, I haven't had a single respring, but there's slight overheating. It's totally usable with no super major issues. The battery life is worse than iOS 13.5.1. I'm getting about 1 hour less screen on time. That's pretty bad considering I was getting bad battery life on iOS 13. So in conclusion, this is a great update. For the iPhone, it's a major update and could even make people switch from Android, which doesn't happen with every update. There are fundamental changes to many parts of the OS, and they actually make changes to your daily life. So if you have been thinking of getting the public beta for the iPhone SE, I would say it depends. If you're okay with some minor bugs and worse battery life by about an hour, then I would say it's not a bad idea. Performance is good though, and of course the feature set is great. I really like this update and I can't wait for the final version. As always, please like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.